You mentioned open partnerships with developers. How is it possible that the business interest for all these players will be met? And how Nokia can help to ensure that?
It's a good question. Let's start first from who these players are. And obviously, it's the service providers, it's the mobile operators, and of course the application providers or the application platform providers. And then it's the industry players, and even the governments behind them, is the Internet of Things service providers, and it's of course the infrastructure equipment or software vendors such as us, Nokia. And all these players will have to work together for this ecosystem play to work out, and of course it will evolve as we learn. But it starts from the service providers, it starts from the mobile operators, because if you think that you purchased, you developed this nice capability of exposing APIs to the partners, to the OTT players, and then you think you can sit back and enjoy and wait that this will happen, you are greatly mistaken, because you have to just be proactive. You have to do hackathons, you have to run real startup incubation programs, and you have to build on that. You have to draw innovation, local talent to differentiate yourself from the others. But then, of course, it's quite encouraging to see that there are already application developers, serious, well-known brands that has recognized that they need to rely on the mobile operators. They have to have a tighter integration into the mobile operators' network, and they cannot just be connected from the outside. And that is already really encouraging. But this is just a play, and of course, vendors like Nokia can support this process greatly, and we do. One example that we have kicked off years ago, a platform called Open Ecosystem, that brings together these players, and you can access APIs and SDKs and descriptions and get support through this environment. But also, of course, we support it directly from the exposure side, so that you will have to try your application, whether it works. You have to develop a prototype and showcase that to the operator. And for that, we roll out actually network exposure to public cloud, connected in underneath to an end-to-end network that will help you to demonstrate these capabilities. And I think that's fundamentally important. And of course, we support a lot of these activities. We support hackathons, we participate and even drive startup incubation programs, which means that we are in the heart of it, in the pulse. And of course, industry collaboration in 5G is very important. It gives us an opportunity to learn together with the whole industry to take up this change, this challenge that 5G brings. That will eventually bring us to a success.